No, but you can just do Netflix.
Netflix.
Yeah, just do Netflix. All right.
My wife won the chair. It is the most amazing folding
chair. Hey, Henry, say bye to the internet.
It's her chair, actually. Yes. I can't tell why. It is her chair.
Okay. All right.
She's letting me buy. But it is.
All right, I'm just going to forget that.
Check.
Check. Yeah.
What's happening?
Check.
Czech Republic.
Yep. Okay.
I think it should be. I think we're all friends here. I don't know if I need the microphone, but we'll find out. I'm gonna start with an oldie because I gotta warm up. So.
Damn Bryk, everybody.
All right. I wanted to be Mark Turmell, 'cause he was the best programmer in the whole entire world. And he lived in California. He wrote games for serious software. And I dreamt that he drove a sports car and did lines of coke in the sand. Well, I didn't have I lived in the heart of suburbia, and I took Mississauga Transit. Google that. And I wrote my very own BBS software so I could modem the other geeks, and they could modem me back. I wanted to be Mark Turmell, 'cause he was the coolest programmer in the entire.
You guys are upstairs, right?
Fucking world. Mark Turmell, true story. True story. All right. Not a bouncy one or a sad one? Bouncy one or sad
one?
How about a bouncy sad one? I'm gonna double down on the nerd core here, okay? I need a root kit for your heart, 'cause I'm dying to know what you're thinking. sir. I need a rootkit.
Rootkit.
Yay!
Alright. So I'm delving into some songs that I've never performed for any living human beings before. And some of you know I started this coding boot camp that I've been doing for the last 6 weeks. And all the time I thought I was gonna have to practice for this gig. I had like months I knew about this gig, Michael and I planned for a long time, and it just became time that I was trying to catch up with the boot camp. So here we go. This is actually a song to me. She's upstairs. So this is a song as if I was writing a song to me by my wife. Of course, if our genders were reversed. To figure out whether a song is good is to play it for human beings, I think, because you can play it in your head a million times, like, oh yeah, that's a good one, and so.
I disagree. I think the best way to find out if a song is good is if you followed your inspiration. if you wrote and played what popped into your head, mm-hmm. then it's good. That's my definition.
Michael Holt, ladies and gentlemen. That's why I love him. Every time I just hang out with Michael, I just like So this is from the literal expression of my spouse's feelings to a literal and generous use of her name. Five of you know this song, so it's new to everyone else. A PG-rated set, and I lost. So this is like really so new that I'm just. This has no profanities, but it is adult themed. So, but I think it will go over their heads. So one hopes. And this is called Emily's Tender, which you Thomas the Tank Engine fans will recognize. It's 2:30 and I'm trying to sleep.
better get back to my wife and children and all of this shit till I find a better job. I'm sick of the hot plate and continental breakfast and dressing like a slob. I gotta get hold of my heart and stop tearing yours apart. I better get hold of myself. I guess that I'm going to hell.
And this is the part. Are you guys up for some audience participation? So this is, it sounds like a lot of chords, but it's only three words, so it goes like this. We love you, 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 we love you. Maybe it's a lot of chords. We love you, we love you. One more time, we'll do it. Myself a goal in my 7 years of the hinterlands that I needed to write a power ballad. So, and I learned two things. One, power ballads are called power ballads because they're powerful, and they exert the powers over human beings in a very irrational and unexpected ways. And two, I'm not very good at writing power ballads. But you'll be the judge of that. Sometimes you hold my hand. I hold, let's try that over. Sometimes you hold my hand. I hold my breath to see if I can understand just what you see.
Sometimes I get it right, sometimes I get it wrong. I try with all my might, but all I get's a song. I need you.
Just a generalized ennui song. I've been living in America for 12, 13 years now. And, Merca? Merca? Yes, Merca. Merca, I know. You know, I use the word Merkin, like in a blog post or whatever, like Merkin is short for American or Southern for American. And someone's like, dictionary Merkin. And I stopped doing that. You Google that right now, right? So, but yeah.
Woohoo!
Yeah. All right. Hope I can do this. This is so new I was writing it in the room there 45 minutes ago. So. Couldn't believe my eyes.
to see here.
Everyone's got to write that long Dylan song, right? Like, interminable stanzas. And... All right, this is my last one, because I think you... How are we for time? Do I have time for two or one?
What do you feel like?
Am I going to kill the magic by playing a bad one? That's the question. All right, I'm going to give this
What's popping into your head? That's my...
Two at most. Okay. Two at most. Okay, I'm going to try this. Don't judge me. And if I fail, I'm going to bail on it, because it's like, it's so new. It's like... Like, you know, I've been writing it since November, the second Tuesday in November. I've been writing this since. And it's a lot of chords for me. I don't know if it's a lot of chords for you. You're such a loser, all you ever do is lose. You got no silk tie, no alligator shoes. Your wine comes from a box, three X's on your boots. I got an offer that you really can't refuse. Just let me bend your ear so I can set you straight. I was turned a silver spoon into a golden gate. I was born and bred to win, it was no twist of fate. But you can do it too, I pray it's not too late. Cause I've been winning since the day I was born. But I can help you get it on the factory floor. Just let me in and I will tell you more. We always score. Think about winners as we always. You're just a whiner, just a whiner never was. You never partied with the kings and queens and shops. I got penthouses and a hangar full of cars. You rent a pre-war in the 141s. But I can fix that if you give me a chance. I got a line on romance and high finance. To turn around your very bad circumstance. This was not an autobiographical song. Don't waste a tear on me now. All the damage 'cause I dreamt of being a star, drinking light beer by the pool while the action went down in the hotel bar. My alleged career, my alleged career, my alleged career, watching the treat of the week, get to sleep with the girl that I just wanted to kiss. A peck on the cheek would have done. Now I'm stuck here alone with this dumb bouquet and my alleged career. Who in hell do I think I'm impressing by dressing like I'm 23 years old? My alleged career. Maybe I'm doing this wrong, but this leather thong's hurting my ass. Trying to pass for some kind of cool modern rock masochist when I'm merely a slave to the song called my alleged career. My alleged career. Please go. Alleged career. Thank you very much. Thank you. And thank you so much, Michael Holt, for just being responsible for this. So, thank you guys.
Yeah.
So, we're going to play in 15 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. There we go. Time to refill your drinks, fill up your tummy with a little more food, and trying to depress yourselves. and I think Michael will be a bit more emotionally balanced.
Yes. We'll see.
Thank you, man. All right.
Okay, that was awesome.
Bye, Internet.